This is a relatively simple Bernoulli problem. And what we have is we have air and it flows steadily. So don't have to worry about a DT term. It's through a horizontal pipe that is 10 centimeters in diameter. It exits into the atmosphere through an 8 centimeter nozzle. The pressure in the pipe is 800 pascals. And what we want to know is, what is the velocity at the exit? So let's start by getting rid of some of our variables or our terms in Bernoulli. So if we write that P1 over gamma, or the specific weight, plus V1 squared over 2G plus Z1 equals P2 over gamma plus V2 squared over 2G plus Z2. So P2 equals zero because it's atmospheric. We are working in gauge pressure, so that means that the pressure is zero at atmosphere. In addition, Z1 and Z2 are horizontal, since it's a horizontal pipe. Therefore, we can get rid of Z1 and Z2. So we can simplify this to P1 equals 1/2 times rho V2 squared minus V1 squared. And I just manipulated through to get P1 by itself. So it looks like we only have one equation, but we have two unknowns, V1 and V2. So what we do is we are assuming incompressible flow. We write that V1 A1 equals V2 A2. Therefore, V1 equals A2 over A1 times V2, which equals 0.8 squared over 1 squared times V2. Really, technically, this should be 0.08 squared over 0.1 squared. And therefore, V1 equals 0.64 V2. So we can substitute that into our equation such that P1 equals 1/2 times rho V2 squared minus 0.64 V2 squared. And when we put our numbers in, we have 800 pascals equals 1/2 times the density, 1.23 kilograms per meter cubed. And this equals V2 squared minus 0.64 V2 squared. Remember that 0.64 is squared as well. So this ends up being 0.59 V2 squared. This can be solved. You're going to get two roots because it's a square. However, because one's going to be negative and one's going to be positive, it's pretty simple to choose the right one. So V2 equals 47 meters per second. Even though we weren't asked to do it, we can still solve for V1, which is 30 meters per second. So how could we tell if we can really make that assumption that it is incompressible? Well, if we use the relationship that V over C has to be less than 0.3, and our C can be found by finding the square root of K times R, the gas constant, times T. K is just the ratio of the specific heat. So in order to calculate this, we would have to know the temperature, where C is the speed of sound. But if you look at our velocity and look at that square root of KRT, it looks like at most of the temperatures that this would occur at, that the Mach number, or V over C, is less than 0.3. And we can assume incompressible flow.